I never really had crazy Hollywood parties, because all the crazy Hollywood parties I had, I was having myself when I was doing crack. And those were crazy, and I can't tell you about them, because people didn't even know I was doing it except the people who was getting high with my ass. I was getting fucked up because, you know, I was a hardcore addict. I was one of them addicts who couldn't understand, how the fuck are we going to stop getting high? And it's still dope on this plate. Hand me that razor blade. Anyway, I'll be cutting that shit up right, and I'll be pushing that motherfucker through the stem. I kill for residue. Fucking kill. You know, I could make a crack pipe out of anything. Piece of glass, Coca-Cola can bottle, Tampax, a car antenna. If you came out of your car in the 90s and the antenna was gone, motherfucker, that was me. So them the parties I had. Me, a couple of freaks, a couple of rocks, and a broken piece of glass. You know, I remember one day I had this rock, and I said, I wonder what happened if I put this on this hot piece of glass. It took me 23 years to get past that shit, you know. So them the kind of parties I had. Now my parties are more sober, they're more sensible, and they're more God-based. You know, I wake up in the morning, I feel better, you know. For me, dope was never, I never had a was me moment. I never got high to escape anything. I got high to have fun. You know, I was making money on Venice Beach. You know, I did Venice Beach for 9 years, and I did 5 one-hour shows every Saturday and Sunday, every weekend for 9 years. And every time I leave, I have a fucking sack of money. And I didn't owe nobody nothing. And I think Robin Williams said it best. Cocaine is God's way of saying, you're making too much goddamn money. I had so much money, I didn't owe nobody nothing. And I had friends who liked to get high. And it seemed like they was having fun. So I was getting high, fucking. I was out in these hotels with these bad motherfuckers and having fun. But after you get high, especially with a chemical like crack, a lot of times you can get stuck with one blast. Because the whole thing is, you get high once, and the rest of your life you chasing that high. You never see that motherfucker again, you know? So I would always just go out to have fun. That's why I ain't never do no woe is me shit. Man, getting my dick sucked, smoking them rocks and shit. That's what I was doing. I was partying. So I never had that. Now, I've often felt not as good when I came down, it was over because guilt was slipping in. Now that I think about all the money I fucked up, because I have fucked up more relationships, more money. I mean, I've never owned property. I just bought my first house ever in 3 months ago. I never owned property. I was renting. My last house, I rented for 6 years. I spent $154,000 renting somebody else's shit. You know, I hadn't even known my landlord until one day I looked out the window and a white lady come walking towards my house with a piece of paper. I said, shit, baby, I think we about to move. I don't never want to be a place in my life where I have to be like that again, where I have to worry that somebody gonna come up with a piece of paper and take my shit. So I never had stuff like that because I was busy fucking off my money and my time, thinking I'm having fun, but the whole time, everybody else is marching past me, missing great opportunities. I'm sure why some of the people don't fuck with me is I probably got high and said some ignorant shit to a motherfucker, let my ego get in the game, you know, and didn't realize that it ain't about me, because it really ain't about me. It's really about God. You know, if God is not the answer, then you're asking the wrong question. But one plus God is a majority. Me and God, I'll take on any of you motherfuckers. Come on with it, you know? So I forgot that. When you're getting high, you forget that. And you say, oh, fuck it, I need one more rock. You know, I wish I had a fucking ATM machine in my house. So I just go get one more 20. I just need one more $20 rock to get that ATM. I was thinking about taking one, put one in my house, sit the motherfucking refrigerator right up in the kitchen. I say the only down parts I've ever had is sometime guilt would slip in after high, or after I slept too late to go to an audition, or after I went to an audition thinking that nobody knows. You know, because everybody know you high, but you don't think nobody know you high but you. You know, I'm coming in here, a heart pumping fast, you know, eyes rolling around, my head sweating like R. Kelly in the playground, and thinking that nobody knows. But they all know. They look at your skin and see it's all pasty. They see your energy is not up like it normally is. And they do know. And everybody talked to everybody. So I'm sure I fucked up somewhere and somebody told their friend who told their friend. As the story goes, the story always embellishes. It get worse and worse. And I did some horrific shit that I never really did. But that's how the story sound better when you tell it to the next motherfucker. So I don't even know. And I don't go out like Inspector Gadget, trying to figure the fuck out. Hey, why won't y'all play with me? No, I'm not doing that. I'm doing my shit. I'm unfolding into my greater self every day, being more and more thankful to God and more creative and more positive and trying new things and expanding myself and living just an awesome life. I'm sitting in the middle of my dream, man. Look at that. Y'all got 9 cameras in this motherfucking microphones. My name on the wall and shit. Come on. What the fuck am I going to be mad about? No. It's gratitude, baby. Yeah, if I could talk to the young Michael, if I could talk to me when I was the mini me, the young me, what I would say to myself is, don't experiment in things that you already know is not positive and loving and nurturing for you. Don't take the chance. People always want to be on the wild side, you know? I'm just going to get high because I see people getting high, and I think that's the thing to do. There's enough stories to let me know that you can end up in a terrible crash because of it, but I want to do it anyway. I would say, it's so simple to just say no. It's so simple, you almost say, no, that can't be the answer. That's too easy. But I would say to the younger me, just say no. Think about health. Think about how good food tastes. You know, once I stop getting high, I can taste food again. Food is delicious, you know? So I would say keep it simple. Keep God first. You know, one plus God is the majority. So I would say to myself, think about the beautiful young girls you could be with. And you could be with them more purely if you ain't high, if you focus, if you clear, if you making your paper honestly, you know? So I would say, take it easy, slow down, read more, you know, drink the water, be kind to people. I mean, if you could be anything in the world you want to be, why not be kind? So if you could just be good to everybody, send love out to everybody and give, your life will be so enhanced that you won't have to look over to the side at those things that don't help you. That's what I would say to the young me, you know.